Hi everyone, I'm Soosan Jacob, and in this video I'm going to show you how we made a slit lamp protector shield in view of the increasing coronavirus infection around the world. Now this is important because we as ophthalmologists are exposed straight to the breath of the patient up close, and very often a sneeze reflex may also be elicited when you throw the light into a photophobic patient's eye. Now there's a very beautiful video that was made by Dr. John Canlopoulos on this same topic and shared to ophthalmologists around the world, and I think that's an amazing first video that was made and shared and should be seen by everyone. I just searched online and I found this other video that was uploaded just an hour back, and so obviously many of us are already taking this precaution and I'm really happy about that. I am still making this video and uploading it, and I do hope that it will be useful for you. So this is a slit lamp protective shield that I had created out of a file, a simple plastic file, and the reason I use that is because this is also flexible material. I have loosened the screw that connects the eyepiece to the rest of the slit lamp. So these are the material that are required: a simple flexible file folder made of plastic, a marker pen, a scissor and a blade. If the plastic file is joined along two ends, cut it out so that you can open it up into one long piece. Now you place it in such a way in front of the slit lamp so that you get maximum coverage both above the eyepiece as well as below. So you mark this plastic sheet and then place it over the disconnected eyepiece so that that mark is right at the center, and then draw the circle around the eyepiece so that it's going to fit tightly when you reconnect everything. Now make a small cut on that mark circle with a blade and then cut it all around with a scissor so that you get this hole in the sheet. This is now placed around the eyepiece that was disconnected, and the eyepiece is screwed back on to the rest of the slit lamp. Now this acts as a very stable breath shield, and you can see patients easily. It is important to make sure that as your hands go around the sides of the shield, you actually flex or fold the shield outwards and not inwards towards you, so that your hand does not or your arm does not touch the patient's side of the breath shield. As you can see, most procedures can be done easily with the shield in place since it's flexible material, and it can also be easily cleaned. You can clean it in between patients as well as whenever you want to do it more thoroughly by taking it off in the similar manner and placing it with the patient side up and cleaning it with Sterilim or any other alcohol based wipe. So you can see that this can be adapted very well to other slit lamp models as well in a similar manner, and we have got this placed for all the slit lamps in our department. I do hope this and all the other videos on this topic will be useful for you. Stay safe, friends. Take care and bye.